Today I'm serving up not popcorn in my Eras Tour collectible popcorn bucket, but book recommendations for 1989 Taylor's version, which comes out today. Hello, Tandem Fandom. My name is Alexis, and welcome to the Tandem Collective, where you can find the latest book recommendations, releases, and news from Team Tandem. You may remember a couple of months ago the video that we put out with book recommendations paired with tracks from Speak Now Taylor's version to celebrate the release of that album. Well, incredibly, today she is coming out with her next Taylor's version album, which is the iconic 1989. I can't wait to listen to this re-recorded album, see what the bonus tracks are, the new bonus tracks, and just hear this album in her current voice. So Bookish Swifties, in your 1989 era, this video is for you, because I'm going to be giving you recommendations of books paired to songs from 1989. Hopefully these books will keep you in that mood and keep that spirit up. I know that for some of these books, when I read them, some of these tracks were just playing over and over in my mind, and they fit the mood and the song perfectly. So I hope you enjoy these recommendations, and we're gonna dive right in, beginning right with the first track on 1989. Welcome to New York encapsulates the excitement and possibilities that New York City has to offer, especially for those that are just arriving there looking to start something new or pursue their dreams. Before getting into my main book recommendation for Welcome to New York, I have an honorable mention, which is One Last Stop by Casey McQuiston, who is the author of Red, White, and Royal Blue and I Kiss Sarah Wheeler. This sapphic romance takes place in New York, of course, specifically on the Q train, where a modern day college student meets a 1970s punk rock lesbian who is somehow lost in time. I also have a team recommendation from Juliana on Team Tandem. She thought that Book Lovers by Emily Henry was a really good match for Welcome to New York. It takes place partially in New York, and both of the main characters live there, I believe. I haven't read that one yet. I've read Emily Henry's Beach Read and You and Me on Vacation. So let us know in the comments if you think that Book Lovers is a good fit for Welcome to New York. My main book recommendation for Welcome to New York is A Shot in the Dark by Victoria Lee. I recently read this book after it was recommended during an Instagram live that we did with Rachel Runya Katz, who's the author of Thank You for Sharing, which we did a read-along of last month. I am so grateful to Rachel for recommending this book, because I fell in love with it. A Shot in the Dark follows Ellie Shava Cohen, or Ellie. And Ellie, in the beginning of this book, is returning to New York after 8 years away. She had been in a very orthodox Jewish community, and she had left that all behind and moved to LA, where she had some struggles, but she also developed her passion and her skills for photography. So 8 years after leaving New York, Ellie is returning there for a photography program that she has been accepted into. Coming back to New York for Ellie is a way to reinvent herself. When we first dropped our bags on apartment floors, took our broken hearts, put them in a drawer. Everybody here was someone else before. And that's really what New York is all about. It can be a chance to start over, reinvent yourself, just as Taylor talks about in her song. It's a new soundtrack. I could dance to this beat forevermore. This is a gorgeous dual point of view love story, and I don't want to give that much away, because I went into this knowing very little about the characters and the story, but there is LGBTQ plus representation. And you can want who you want, boys and girls. And the entire book and the descriptions of the environment that these characters are in really read as a love letter to New York. The next book recommendations I have for you are for Blank Space. Blank Space was Taylor's response to the very heavy media coverage and criticism of her dating life. Media coverage was saying that she dated boy after boy after boy. It was very slut-shaming, and it speculated about why she couldn't hold down a man and what must be wrong with her. So Blank Space was Taylor's satirical comeback in which she played on this inevitability of all of her relationships crashing and burning, according to the media, calling herself insane and a nightmare.
Cause darling, I'm a nightmare dressed like a daydream.
It's biting and just a little bit spiteful and really calling out the media on the slut shaming and on the criticism that she received for her personal life. My honorable book recommendation for Blank Space is They Never Learn by Lane Fargo. It follows Scarlett, who is an English professor, and every year she seeks out the worst guy that she can find on campus and murders him in order to, I suppose, satisfy that craving that she has. But I've got a blank space, baby, and I'll write your name. The school and the community start to catch on and investigate what's going on with these yearly murders. And at the same time, there's a student who is plotting revenge on the boy that attacked and assaulted her friend. So this book is about revenge. It's about spite, and in the case of the professor, Scarlett, it's about filling that blank space with whoever is the worst guy she can find. The main recommendation I'm going to give for Blank Space is The X Talk by Rachel Lynn Solomon. This is an enemies to lovers workplace romance that I listened to a couple of years ago, and it was so much fun. I absolutely fell in love with the characters Shay and Dominic. Shay is a radio producer who really wants to become a host of her own show at her radio network. So when she pitches the idea for a show called The X Talk, in which two exes give relationship advice on air live, she's really excited about it. However, the network wants her to have a co-host, so they fill that blank space, so to speak, with Dominic, who is one of her co-workers. Shay and Dominic have to pretend to be exes on this radio show, which isn't all that hard because they really don't like each other. They are work nemeses. And so they make up a 3-month dating life history. And it's not all that difficult to come up with all the little things that cause the destruction of this fake relationship. All of this culminates in an enemies to lovers, workplace romance, fake dating roller coaster that you get to go on with Shay and Dominic. It's really entertaining watching them trying to maintain this fake relationship while live on air, while also developing some very real feelings for each other, as you might imagine. And it brings to mind certain lines from Blank Space, like, okay, the next song I'm going to match some books with, I'm very excited about because this is one of the first songs that really made me get Taylor Swift, if that makes sense. And that is Out of the Woods. I used to think this song was sort of boring and repetitive and musically not that interesting, but that's when my friend Nicole told me that the reason that it's so repetitive is because it's really about anxiety. And when you have anxiety, you often get these repeating thoughts going over and over in your head about things that you are nervous about, things that make you anxious. And it's very start, stop, start, stop within the narrative of this song. And it's also reflected in the musical arc of this song. Anyway, book recommendations. So my honorable mention for Out of the Woods is ACOTAR, and not necessarily the entire series, but particularly the first book, A Court of Thorns and Roses. The very beginning of it takes place in the woods, as it were. And the main character, Feyre, and her family are in a bit of a desperate situation. They are very poor. They are nearly starving. And Feyre is the only one in her family who is going out and hunting and trying to provide food for her family. And the inciting incident of this book and of really the entire series is Feyre being in the woods and hunting down a wolf in the woods. And wolves also make an appearance in the music video for Out of the Woods, so just thought of that one. So that is my honorable book mention for Out of the Woods. We also had a Team Tandem recommendation from Juliana, who recommended For the Wolf by Hannah Witten. And she says this is mainly because of the drama of the story and the song, but also, of course, because it takes place in the woods. It's a Little Red Riding Hood retelling, which has also been on my TBR for quite some time. However, my main book recommendation for Out of the Woods is One Day in December by Josie Silver. At the beginning of this book, Laurie is on a sidewalk at a bus stop in London, and her eyes meet with this guy on a double-decker bus, and they have this moment. You are looking at me. And she goes home to her best friend and roommate, Sarah, and says, I saw this guy on the bus, and I don't know what it was about him, but it felt like there was some kind of weird connection there, and she's just obsessed with the idea of him and can't stop thinking about him. Doesn't see him for a long while, and then at a Christmas party, best friend Sarah brings her new boyfriend, and guess who it is? It is guy from the bus, whose name is Jack. So this romance follows Laurie and Jack over 10 years as they keep missing each other, whether they're in relationships with other people or there's distance, but it's lots of missed opportunities and will they ever get together or is it just not meant to be? Baby, like we stood a chance, two paper airplanes flying, 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 and I remember thinking. And this kind of snowballing of, okay, now will they get together and now will they get together, that you really feel in Out of the Woods. Are we out of the woods? Are we out of the woods? Are we out of the woods? So that is my main recommendation for that song, is One Day in December by Josie Silver. Moving right along, the next book recommendations that I have pair with the song Style. Now, Style is thought to be possibly Taylor Swift's best written pop song ever. Like the name of the song, it evokes Hollywood glitz and glamour and a love that is enduring and, as she says, never goes out of style. The team recommendation I have for this one comes from Elle, and Elle recommended pairing Style with The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. However, I'm actually going to save that recommendation for another song that I think might be an even better fit. You'll have to tell me in the comments whether you think Seven Husbands goes better with Style or the pairing I'm going to recommend later on in this video. And the honorable mention I have for Style is the book Will They or Won't They by Ava Wilder. This romance follows two Hollywood actors who are on a hit paranormal TV show, and they have to reunite in order to film the final season of this show where their characters are madly in love. Little does the audience know that these two actors had a fling during season one of filming that ended disastrously. So it's a romance, so you can see where this story is going and why, with this second chance lovers romance and the glitz of the TV show and the glamour of Hollywood, I might pair it with Style. And I got that red. The main book recommendation I have for style is Sweet Cheeks by Kay Bromberg. This follows Sailor, who is a baker. She has a bakery called Sweet Cheeks, and it's not doing very well because her ex-fiance keeps turning business away from her. Enter onto the scene her first love, Hayes Whitley, who left her unceremoniously without a word 10 years ago to pursue being a Hollywood star. Now coming back to his hometown as this big Hollywood movie star, Hayes and Sailor meet again as adults, and Hayes attempts to help her with her bakery and reconnect with her. The reason that I paired Sweet Cheeks with style is partially because, of course, the Hollywood glamour of Hayes being a movie star, but also because originally when they dated the 10 years previously, clearly that relationship and love was very young, very inexperienced and destructible, and sort of imploded when Hayes left. And that is the sort of thing that Taylor also describes in her lyrics in style. Of course, having not spoken for 10 years, there's a lot of speculation and tabloid media coverage around Hayes being a famous movie star. And so Sailor doesn't always know what's true and what isn't. As the title suggests, it is a really sweet second chance lovers bakery romance. And if you haven't read any of Kay Bromberg's other romance books, I highly recommend it. Next up is the final song in the standard edition of the 1989 album, which is Clean. For this one, I have honorable mention The Maid, which is a bit self-explanatory. It is about a maid whose passion really is cleaning, but I pair it with Clean because at the end of this book, you really feel like everything is tied together nicely. It feels like a clean slate, and it's very satisfying. Not to say that there isn't more that could happen, because there is a sequel coming out to The Maid next month called The Mystery Guest, which I'm very excited for. We also had another team recommendation from Elle on Team Tandem, and she recommended the book Clean by Juno Dawson, which is about a young socialite who almost overdoses and then is forced into a drug rehab facility. Also pretty self-explanatory. I'm told that there is a romantic arc in there as well. So that is Elle's recommendation for pairing Clean the book with Clean the song. My main book recommendation for Clean is I'm Glad My Mom Died by Jeanette McCurdy. This book made a huge splash in the last year, primarily I think because of its very eye-catching and controversial title. In this book, Jeanette, who is an actor and was a lead role on the show iCarly on Nickelodeon many years ago, talks about her turbulent relationship with her mother and how it shaped her life. She opens up about her complicated relationship with her mother, who was abusive physically and emotionally to Jeanette throughout her life and caused many, many mental illness struggles and addiction struggles with Jeanette. And through all these ups and downs with her mom, of course, it's quite complicated because she still loves her mother, but she realizes that it's a toxic relationship and that it has taken over her life. Jeanette's mom sadly passes away when Jeanette is still a young adult, and as sad as this is, you can also hear and feel the relief in Jeanette's voice that she no longer has to contend with her mother's influence, her abuse, and her extreme disruption in her own life. When I was drowning, that's when I could finally breathe. So like in the lyrics that Taylor wrote for Clean, Jeanette misses her mom, but at the same time feels relief and like a clean slate, like she's finally free.
10 months sober, I must admit, just because you're clean don't mean you don't miss it.
There are so many hit songs on 1989 that I couldn't fit them all into this video. So before I go into the final song that I have paired books with for you, I have a few extra song mentions from myself and the rest of the team. For the song All You Had to Do Was Stay, Juliana recommended Before I Let You Go by Kennedy Ryan. Juliana also recommended for the song I Wish You Would, Happy Place by Emily Henry, another Emily Henry recommendation. Elle also had a recommendation for Wonderland, which is one of the bonus tracks on the deluxe 1989 album. And that was If We Ever Meet Again by Anna Huang, who you may know as the author of the Twisted Lies, Twisted Games books. I also really wanted to include a couple of recommendations for Bad Blood. It's a song that's quite fiery and vengeful, has a lot of girl power. And the books that came to mind for this song for me were all about female leads that have this power and drive, and oftentimes that drive is fueled by revenge. So the first book is The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo by Stieg Larsson. There is also Carrie by Stephen King, think about it, Bad Blood. Witches Steeped in Gold is another one which Jenny actually recommended in our Witchy Reads video from a couple of weeks ago. And then finally, These Violent Delights by Chloe Gong, which is a Romeo and Juliet retelling that takes place in 1920s Shanghai and has to do with rival gangs. But the final song from 1989 I'm going to be pairing books with is Wildest Dreams. This is a huge fan favorite from this album. It's very nostalgic. It evokes a lot of 1930s, 40s, golden Hollywood vibes, and the music video is absolutely gorgeous. Most of the narrative of this song centers around doomed love and epic love stories. So Elle actually had a team recommendation for Wildest Dreams, and that is This Is Gonna End in Tears by Liza Klausman. And I really couldn't decide between these two books for my main recommendation for Wildest Dreams. So I'm just gonna give you both of them. The first one I alluded to earlier, and that is The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. If you're unfamiliar with this book, it follows Evelyn Hugo recounting her seven marriages that she's had over many decades and a very successful Hollywood career. Although she had been married seven times, Evelyn only had one true forbidden love throughout her entire life. This book follows their epic love story right from their first meeting to long separations, secret rendezvous, and awful tragedies. It is a beautiful, unexpected love story, and it's been a hit all over bookish social media. The forbidden aspect and the longing that Evelyn and her lover express throughout this book are so in line with the lyrics in Wildest Dreams. Say you remember me, standing in a nice dress, staring at the sunset, babe, red lips and rosy cheeks. Say you'll see me again, even if it's just in your wildest dreams. My final book recommendation and pairing with Wildest Dreams is Divine Rivals by Rebecca Ross. When I tell you that I had Wildest Dreams in my head throughout reading this story, I mean, it was incessant. This is a YA fantasy, and the world is inspired by World War I aesthetics and technology. There's also a war going on in this book. However, it is a war between gods that unfortunately they have swept the humans up in. We meet Iris Winnow and Rowan Kitt, who are rival journalists at the same newspaper. Iris also has this typewriter that seems to have some kind of magical powers, because when she writes letters on it and slips them beneath the door of her closet in her room, they disappear. And she starts getting letters back from this mysterious boy named Carver. The art of letter writing is so nostalgic and just reminded me so much of Wildest Dreams. You can see here on this is the Fairy Loot Edition sprayed edge. And throughout the book, Iris doesn't know if she will ever meet this mystery boy Carver who writes her letters or not. In fact, the bookmark, which I have read the full book, but I just stuck the bookmark in there because it's for this book, says, "I think it's better this way, that we keep our identities secret." So it really fits when you have lyrics from Wildest Dreams like, that combined with the setting of this book in World War I, which is not exactly the setting of the music video of Wildest Dreams, but it's got this like golden age aspect to it. It's just beautiful. And again, you really feel that longing between Iris and her letter writer. And then she eventually goes off to war and doesn't even know if she'll be coming back. She certainly won't be coming back the same person as she left as. The sequel to Divine Rivals comes out on the 26th of December. It is the final book in this duology, and it is called Ruthless Vows. And I cannot wait to read that book. I feel like I will again have Wildest Dreams stuck in my head throughout the reading of Ruthless Vows. It's a really beautiful story. This first one, Divine Rivals, and I highly recommend picking it up and maybe having Wildest Dreams on in the background as you're reading. So I'm going to bookend it there for today. That concludes my 1989 Taylor's Version book recommendations. If you have book recommendations paired to 1989 songs, please drop them in the comments. I would absolutely love to see what you would recommend. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe for more bookish content from Team Tandem. You can sign up for our newsletter by going to the bottom of the video description and clicking that link, and that way you will get all of our latest creator opportunities straight into your inbox. You can also find us on Instagram and on TikTok. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy 1989 Taylor's Version, and I'll see you in the next video.